welcome back to my channel. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. Today I am going to be doing my 16 and 17 week pregnancy vlog. I also want to talk about makeup mayhem. I don't know if you guys have heard of that, but Miss Glamorazzi here on YouTube invented this kind of term a few years back. What it is it's basically a challenge for beauty vloggers here on YouTube to create a video on their beauty channel pretty much every day for the month of May. So I decided, since I'm feeling a lot better in my pregnancy now and I have a little more time on my hands, that I'm going to try my best to participate in makeup mayhem. So you may see me wearing the same outfits in two different videos, because I will be pre-recording some videos since I am pregnant to allow for sick days or migraine days or things like that, or just busy days. So I do want to participate and upload a video every single day. So if you are new, definitely subscribe to my channel, because I'm going to be doing lots of beauty videos this month, and I'm also taking your requests. If you guys have any requests for makeup mayhem, please feel free to leave them down below. Also, I want to do a Q&A during this month, so if you guys have any questions to ask me, whether it be personal or beauty related, you guys can also leave that down below as well, and I'll just compile those all together and create a video for that. So I'm going to go ahead and head into my pregnancy vlog today and just get started. Here we go. Okay, so today I am 17 weeks pregnant. I am really excited because it feels like I just found out just yesterday that I was pregnant. Like, the weeks are literally flying by. So when people tell you that pregnancy flies by and to enjoy every minute, believe it. Definitely, I'm freaking out that I'm 17 weeks today. It's almost halfway over. 20 weeks, I'll be halfway through my pregnancy. So I did have a few changes. I know in my last vlog, the 15 week vlog, I told you guys I was feeling extremely fabulous. I just had a really great week that week. Things have changed up a bit. I am starting to feel better now, but in the 16th week, I will say I was a little bit tired again. I was feeling a little bit sleepy, and you know, I hadn't felt like that since the first trimester. And one of the main symptoms that I've been having is migraines. Luckily, this past week, I haven't had any migraines, but my 16th week, I had a migraine that lasted for 3 days. I was completely miserable. I was in bed for all 3 days. I couldn't do anything. Like, my kitchen literally became a disaster because I couldn't get up to clean. I just was in bed. All I did was shower, eat, and just lay there. That's it. I couldn't do anything. So I did talk to my doctor and told her that I was experiencing debilitating migraines, and they did prescribe Tylenol 3 for me, so it's completely safe. I was a little bit worried because it does have codeine, but again, I will take the regular Tylenol first and see if that works, but it hasn't so far when I've had a migraine. So it will be my last resort, though. I don't want to resort to taking lots of medicines during my pregnancy. But that is the option that she gave me. So as far as this week, I have been feeling a little bit better. I haven't really been as tired. I've noticed I've been staying awake a lot longer, and I told you guys that a while back. I've been able to get a lot more done in the house in one period of time. Before, I would have to, like, basically just kind of straighten up and clean one room, like maybe dust it and, like, sweep, and then take a break and then move on to the next room. And I'm finding that I'm getting, like, larger areas of the house done before I get tired and I need to take a break. And if you are pregnant, it is very important to take breaks because you can't push yourself too hard. And I am going to put on my lifestyle channel, if you guys haven't subscribed over there, be sure to go and subscribe, because I am doing, you know, baby related things, pregnancy related things, wife related things, household things like that. And I am going to talk about products that have made my cleaning life kind of easier during pregnancy, because, you know, I'm not supposed to mop or any of that stuff. So I've found alternatives, because I am a little bit OCD when it comes to my house. I do like things to be pretty neat and clean. So, and especially, you know, I'm kind of starting to nest. That's another symptom. So I've had to find ways to make things a lot easier and to find products that are safe for me to use during pregnancy. So that has been, you know, one of my challenges from the beginning, but I'm able, like I said, to get my house a lot cleaner now. And so I'm excited about that. I kind of feel like, you know, things are starting to look like up to par to my standards. And I did find out the gender of my baby, so I do already know what I'm having, but I'm not going to release that news quite yet to you guys. I haven't really released it on social media at all, only because I feel like during pregnancy, you know, a lot of people like to make, I guess, give you unsolicited advice and make comments and things like that. And although I am so excited to share my joy with everybody, I feel like at this point in time, I just want to keep it private and just really let it all sink in and enjoy, you know, the news with my close friends and family for a while before I actually release it to everybody else. So I will be sharing that with you guys very soon in an upcoming video, so you guys can expect that. And that is pretty much all the symptoms that I've had for those past 2 weeks. Now, as far as cravings, the one thing that I've been craving a lot of is the orange soda, like Fanta. That's what I've been craving a lot of, which is really bad because normally I'll drink caffeine-free Diet Coke or Fresca, like if I'm craving soda, but I've just switched over to orange soda. I don't know what the problem is. I don't know why I'm craving it so much, and I'm back to craving pizza again. So leave it to me to crave two really fattening things. But the good news is I've only gained 2 pounds. I went back and they were super surprised that I've only gained 2 pounds and I'm this far along. So I am walking now. I just started walking again. The weather has been really nice at night because during the day here it's just scorchers in Texas. So I have been trying to walk in the evenings, and I will say that it is very difficult to exercise during pregnancy compared to when you're not pregnant. You know, I went walking last night and I actually went to a track so I could calculate, you know, how much I was walking. And when I first found out I was pregnant, I would walk 2 miles like nothing. And you know, I could probably even go for like 3 miles or 4 miles if I wanted to, but you know, everybody was after me not to push myself. So I was walking last night and I calculated, and you know, at 3/4 of the mile, like I had to really push myself to finish that mile. And you know, at that point I had to stop because when you're pregnant again, you can't push yourself, it's dangerous. So I just need to really build up my stamina. My legs just feel different. You know, your stomach gets rounder, so it changes the center of gravity for you. So I just really feel a lot different. So I am trying to get more active, and I have found on Amazon, I do have Amazon Prime, some prenatal yoga videos and some prenatal like aerobic videos. So I'm gonna try to do some of those as well, because my goal is to tone up what I can while I'm pregnant as far as like my legs and my arms, so that way I can kind of lose everything afterwards, because you guys do know that I've had thyroid issues and I was losing weight before the baby. So maybe we can go back to weighing Wednesdays after I have the baby, so you guys can follow me on my weight loss journey. But I can't really think of anything else that has really changed that's been significant besides that. Yeah, I think that's about it for these past 2 weeks. I'll show you guys the bump for now. And if you guys are pregnant, I am so happy for you. And I've gotten a lot of messages and emails and things like that about people sharing their pregnancy and they haven't told anybody else. And it's just really fun to hear other people's stories. And I love watching vlogs because it's fun to keep up with everybody else's symptoms. But let me get to the bump. Okay, so I'm noticing today, especially through the camera, my bump is looking a lot smaller. There's days that my bump looks really, really big, and then there's days that it looks a lot smaller, like today. Like today just looks like it's a little flattened out. So this is from the front area, and from the front I look a little more preggo. But there's days that I look really, really big, right? Just depending on what I wear. So I guess this shirt is pretty flattering, but this is my bump at 17 weeks. Again, my body's changing and a lot of my shirts are getting loose back here. This is a maternity shirt, so it is a little more flattering on the stomach, but that is my bump for 17 weeks. I hope you guys enjoyed my pregnancy vlog, and don't forget to subscribe, because like I said, I will be uploading videos every day for the month of May. And I really appreciate all the support and you guys sticking around, even though I've been a little bit sporadic with my videos. Thank you guys so much once again for watching, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.